Hello, in this presentation I will give you a brief introduction to the three particle characterization techniques available at MCL and discuss how to select the most appropriate method for your samples. But first, let's discuss what particles are. Particles include solids, liquid droplets or gas bubbles with physical dimensions ranging from sub-nanometer to several millimeters in size. The most common type of material consisting of particles are powders and granules, pigments, cement, pharmaceutical ingredients, suspensions, emulsions and slurries, and also aerosol and sprays. At MCL, we have a range of capabilities to characterize particulate matter. The instruments available are listed in this table, where they are specified by the type of measurement and physical principle those measurements are based on. Particle sizing suite includes three Malvern instruments: zeta sizer, master sizer, and morphology. So, why do we want to measure particle size? Particle size affects so many processes: reactivity of minerals, soil properties, drug delivery, food texture, packing density, and many others. The first attempts to measure particle size were recorded long time ago. For example, in ancient Egypt, people tried to control size fractions. They used sieves to separate wheat from small stones and grass. Although sieving is still a very common technique, other particle sizing techniques have been developed. They can be divided in three groups. Separation methods, where outside force is used to separate particles into different size classes. Ensemble methods, all particles are measured at the same time and size distribution data is extracted from combined signal for all particles. And then counting methods. Individual particles are measured and counts of similar size particles are placed into size bin to construct a size distribution. Here is an example of different techniques for each of these classes: separation techniques, ensemble techniques, and counting techniques. This plot also shows size ranges that they cover. You can observe that each class covers the entire range of particle sizes. For this particular presentation, I will focus on the three particle sizing techniques that are available at MCL: laser diffraction, dynamic light scattering, and automated imaging. Laser diffraction and dynamic light scattering are both ensemble techniques, where we measure combined or bulk signal from all particles. Laser diffraction is based on the measurement of diffracted angles. Small particles diffract at large angles, large particles diffract at low angles. In dynamic light scattering, we measure diffusion coefficient, where small particles diffuse faster, large particles diffuse slower. To simplify the measurement process, we use the concept of equivalent spheres, where particle size is defined by the diameter of equivalent sphere, which has the same property as the actual particle. For example, for laser diffraction, a diameter is defined as the diameter of a sphere that creates the same diffraction pattern as the particle of interest. For dynamic light scattering, it is the diameter of a sphere that diffuses at the same speed as the particle being measured. Automated imaging is a counting technique, where individual particles are measured by microscope, which automatically scans large enough area to get a statistically valid distribution, for example, a few thousand of particles. It gives highly detailed information of size and shape, and it is not biased by the choice of model like in the case of ensemble techniques. There are quite a few things to consider when you try to choose particle sizing technique which is the best for your sample. The first criteria to look at is apparently the expected size range. However, as you see from this plot, size ranges of the techniques overlap, so we need to consider another criteria. Sample form can be important. It depends on the state of your sample is. Is it dry powder, suspension, emulsion, or spray. So for some techniques, not all sample forms work. Another important criteria is a size distribution type. Each technique has its preferred way to present distribution: intensity weighted for dynamic light scattering, volume weighted by laser diffraction, and number weighted by automatic imaging. Here you see a size distribution for a sample that has the same number of 5 nanometer and 50 nanometer particles. Note that the intensity and volume distribution are biased towards larger particles and agglomerates. Another criteria to consider is concentration if you deal with wet dispersed sample, shape. For example, some equivalent sphere models may not work well for particles with irregular shapes. Then another criteria is accuracy and precision. For example, ensemble techniques can be very precise but not accurate because of the assumed model parameters. Automated imaging can be very accurate since no models are involved and we see particles. However, it may be difficult to get reproducible results because of variations in sample dispersion or the choice of selected area. And the last but not least criteria is a measurement time. This is a summary diagram that shows all criteria we discussed for laser diffraction, automated imaging, and DLS. For laser diffraction, we use volume-weighted distribution. For automated imaging, number-weighted distribution, and for DLS, intensity-weighted. As for the concentration, DLS has the most wide concentration range, while for two other methods, concentration range is restricted. Laser diffraction and DLS model all particles as spheres, while automated imaging provides a detailed size and shape information for each single particle. Then, both dry and wet samples can be utilized by laser diffraction and automated imaging, but DLS deals with wet dispersion only. As discussed before, laser diffraction and DLS can be very reproducible but may not be accurate for non-round particles. At the same time, automated imaging is very accurate but may not be very precise between replicates. Finally, it takes longer for automated imaging, measurement, and data processing than for the two other techniques. So there are a few things to be considered when you choose the most appropriate particle sizing technique, such as what particle size range you want to cover, type and resolution of distribution needed, how much sample you have. Do you want to study aggregates or fine particles? Do you have sample in a powder or suspension form? How your material is used in application, wet or dry? And how much time do you want to spend for the measurement? So the take-home message is that each technique generates a different result since different physical properties of the samples are measured. Particle counting and ensemble techniques can complement each other, although may not be in agreement for non-round particles. It is important to know how size information helps your application and why you need to measure particle size. Finally, you can find short videos with more details on each particle sizing techniques on the MCL website.